So in this video, we're going to talk about equations of sine and cosine functions with changing amplitude and midlines. So let's start with a review of what you already know. If we have an equation like this, the 2 here tells us the amplitude, and the 1 tells us the midline, right? Or the vertical shift and the vertical stretch, if you will. The pi here tells us the period, or is related to the period. We're not going to worry about that part right now. So if we were to look at a graph of this, we can see the midline through the middle here, and the amplitude here is 2. Now notice that the midline is a horizontal line here because it's always at y equals 1, and the amplitude is always 2 here because it's constant, because it is always 2. So our first thing that we're going to look at is what would happen if we changed, I'm going to go ahead and make my amplitude 1 here. What would happen if instead of using a constant here, we were to use some kind of equation? So let's do the simplest equation we can think of, which is the equation of a line. So remember, lines look like mx plus b. So imagine we had something like y equals 2x plus 1. What would we expect to see here? So here we can see a graph of y equals 2x plus 1, the line we were talking about. So in this equation, we're talking about adding the sine function onto the line. And so if we do that, it's going to sum the two functions together, and we're going to oscillate above and below that line. Let me change the slope here a bit to something a little smaller so we can see it better. And here you can see that the line is acting like a midline, that it's acting as the midline, and the graph is oscillating above and below that midline, just as we would expect if this was, in fact, now the midline. Now we can do the same sort of thing with non-lines, non-linear functions. So we could, for example, add some other kind of function on. For example, maybe we could use something like 2 times 1.2 to the x, which would be an exponential function. Now it's no longer technically a midline, though often we still call it that. It's more of a mid-function now. But if we were to sketch a graph of that, you can see the exponential function, the 2 times 1.2 to the x here in blue, that's acting as sort of the midline or mid-function. And when we add it to the sine function oscillates above and below that sort of midline type function. Now, this is a very reasonable way to model things like populations that oscillate above and below an average value while the average value is increasing exponentially. So it is not uncommon to see this type of model actually used. Okay, so that looks at changing midlines. Next, let's look at changing amplitudes. So this equation would have a constant amplitude of 2. Now let's imagine that the amplitude was changing. Now the amplitude is the function, is what multiplies the sine function, and so we still need to be multiplying the sine function. But now instead of being constant, imagine that this was changing. So one possibility is it could be, let's say, some kind of decreasing line. And if we had this decreasing line, we'd get a graph like this. In this case, the midline is constant at 0, but the amplitude, you can see the 2 minus 0.2x here, line shown in blue, we're oscillating above and below the midline up to that decreasing decreasing amplitude. Likewise, if we could have an equation like, maybe like, actually let's try like 0.5x times sine pi x. So here our amplitude would start at 0 and be increasing by 0.5 for each x. Let's see what that looks like. So if we bring our slope down to 0 and our starting value down to zero and our slope to 0.5, here we can see a increasing amplitude. If I decrease the slope a little bit, maybe you can see that even better. Now, linearly changing amplitudes are kind of weird, because if you think about a negative one, if the amplitude ever hits zero, then it ends up sort of inverting the function and changing the shape kind of in odd ways. A much more common type of equation that you see in the real world is an exponentially changing amplitude. A great example of this would be, of where you would see this, would be if you imagine a object hanging from a spring and you pull it down and release it. The spring is going to bounce up and down, but as friction and air resistance applies, the amplitude of that oscillation is going to get smaller and smaller and smaller. It's never going to hit zero or go negative, but it's going to decrease. It ends up decreasing exponentially. So, for example, if we did 2 times 0.5 to the x, this would be a decreasing exponential. And let's see what that looks like. And here you can see we have an exponentially decreasing amplitude, and the function is again oscillating above and below the midline, going up to that amplitude. Now, it might actually help here to also graph negative 0.5 to the x, so you can see that it's actually oscillating between this function and its vertical reflection. So we could also try something that had a positive growth rate. So for example, 1.3 to the x, and let me try down here. Oops, I think I made a typo there. 1.3 to the x. You can see our increasing, sorry, I made another typo. There we are. So now we have an exponentially increasing amplitude, and again the graph is oscillating above and below these functions, using this function, using the amplitude function to describe the amplitude of the oscillations. So there you go. What we just talked about are sort of two different ways to change the graph of a trig function, either by making the midline not constant, either a linear midline or an exponential midline, or we can change the amplitude. And again, we can do linear amplitudes or exponential amplitudes, or really we can use any function for those two. The linear and exponential are the most common. And these are very helpful for describing the way things really change when they oscillate.